Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. In this week's sewing class we're gonna make an Indian dress, and it will be my last summery garment that we're gonna make this year, because then we go into some fall pieces. So this one is a dress that I wanted to make for quite some time. I have the fabric now already for I think more than 10 years, but it's so beautiful that I'm always afraid to cut it up. And it's a nice, more like of a watercolor print, so it's very nice to have. And it's a bit of a silky fabric, but it is a viscose. And I also had a pattern for quite some time. I changed a little bit now because I needed to show you how to make it. But it has some draping, but very simple, easy one, so also beginners can do it. But I showed you a while ago this book, and it has all kinds of drapings, how you can draw the pattern for that. And also some origami, and it's really nice things that you can do with a normal simple garment, but you get some options how to make some different things in it. So I really recommend this book. I'm not sponsored or anything, but I really like it. So maybe if you are into draping, or if you want to learn how to make patterns for draping, certainly take this book. And I have also a YouTube channel that is really nice if you are somewhat more experienced and you like to do some more of draping. She has really nice designs. She's called Fifi Style or Fifi Style, I'm not sure how to pronounce it. It's a really nice channel if you want to do some more draping. So I'll show you now what kind of dress we're gonna make for the Indian summer dress. So, and this is what I saw on a dress on ASOS. And it's a really nice evening gown, but what was different is the slit in the front that I also decided for my dress. But underneath it, there in this case, it is a sort of lining that has also a slit, but it is lower. So what I wanted to do is put a lining underneath it in a matching color and make that also lower than that the slit ends. So you see in the slit, you see the lining fabric, but now showing out. So not really as a lining, but more as an other fabric. And I don't think I will do it like this, because here the lining also has a slit. I think I will do it just on the length that I want the lining to be. So how we're gonna make the dress? We have the top part here. We make some pleats here at the shoulder seam and some pleats here at the bottom. Just open arms, a V-neck, then the skirt going nicely out. I make mine as usual midi length, so that will be around 80 centimeters for me, but I'm sure for you it will be much more because I'm just a shorty. But I rather wide skirt. Here with some kind of a slit, it's just because we overlap it a little bit and the rest falls open. And what I showed you, I really like it when here that underskirt, or how you want to call it, lining or whatever it is peeking out. What you can do, as in the inspo picture, you can also make it a little bit longer and then give that lining a slit too. That's very nice too, but I think I'll just make my lining the length that I want it to be and just leave it like that. And I will make it out of a different fabric than the outer fabric, because my fabric is a little bit sheer, and because it is printed, it doesn't look nice when the fabric underneath is shining through, because then it gets very busy here where the fabric is doubled up. So I'm not gonna do that. And then for the back, we have our darts in the top, in the bodice, and in the bottom of the skirt, of course. We have a zipper in the mid-back. I make my bodice rather fitted. I was a little bit debating whether I wanted it wider with some elastic in the waist, but I decided to do it just more fitted on, and then the skirt also going out. And I give it a little bit of a V in the back neck hole, just to give it something different than just the standard rounded neck hole. So that is the whole dress. I'm gonna try to not line the bodice, but I'm not sure if I can do it. I have to figure out if it's too thin or if I can get away with it. If I have to line it, I will line it just with a plain fabric. If not, then I will just make a facing here. Don't know if you can see it with my pencil. Just a facing here around the neck hole and the armhole opening, because then it's very easy to finish here the curves. And it is also a little bit reinforced because the face, you always put some interfacing on your face. Or not always, but in this case, because the fabric is rather thin, you will put that on that there. So I'll let you know later on when we cut the fabric, if I'm gonna line it or not, or if I'll just do the facing part. Then for the fabric, I have this really beautiful fabric that I, as I said, have for years and years because I love it so much. And now finally I'm gonna use it. It has this some kind of watercolored print on it, and it is a viscose, but it feels like silk. It's very soft and shiny, not like satin, but more it's a soft shine and a soft feel to it. So it's not stretchy, but it is very, very flowy, and I just really like the print. It's such a beautiful color painting print. So for your pattern, you will need your basic pattern for a top or dress, and if you don't have that already, I will link it up here and down in the description box, my sewing class, how you can make this to your own sizing. You use that, and what you do is you make a copy of the part until the waist, and you mirror that so that you get one pattern for your whole front bodice. We don't need the dart, so you don't have to mark that, but you need to mark how low you want your V to be, and I already marked that all my basic pattern, how low I want something to be, a V or a rounded neck or whatever. So mark that too on your new piece of paper. Then what you have is this, so it's mirrored, so you have your whole front bodice. Then what you do is I draw a line here across from the bottom of the armhole to the other side of the bottom of the armhole. And then for the pleats, I have to put my scissors here because otherwise it will curl up. For the pleats, you make some straight lines going from the waist up to one point, because that is easiest to do. We're not gonna do the cutting and the pleats like you officially should do. If you want to know how to do it a really right way, watch that book that I already told you, or watch Fifi Styles' video. She really does it the way it should be, but I want to be this sewing class is also for beginners, so I do it in a very simple and easy way with also a great result. So it's not that difficult now, but you can certainly do it if you have never done this before. So you make now some straight lines going all the way up to one point here on that line that you just made. I made three stripes, and then you cut that in so that you can flare that out. And I will do that after this clip. I'll show you on a new piece of paper again how you flare this out and how you make those extra parts for your pleats. And you do the same here for the pleats on the shoulder part. Make three straight lines going onto one point on that same line so that you can flare that out later on. Then you take a new piece of paper. It doesn't have to be this big as this one. You can also just use strips underneath these pieces that you're gonna flare out. Then you have flared this out. I put some yellow paper on it so you can see it. You have something like this. And what you see, because you flare this out, we get here an overlap between the top part and the bottom part. And same here on this side. And what I'm gonna do is on this part, I just very easily just add this part of my bottom piece of the bodice. I'm gonna add that to the bottom here. And you can just very easily do that by cutting it off here where it is overlapping with the top part. And as I said, this is not the way you learn it in school, but it is a very simple way to do this. And I think the result is just the same. Again, tape that down if my tape wants to cooperate. Then you have something like this on this side, and when you gather it in, this goes up. And you get again the same side curve and the same armhole curve. On this side it is a little bit more complicated because you cannot just cut off and add on. What you can do is take over this curve that you should have now, and just add this piece here on your shoulder part, because I don't really want to mess up here with my V part here. If you're really gonna curve this out, then you can get some trouble here with your straight V. So I'm not gonna do that. I'm just gonna put my armhole up here where it should be, like this, just by putting on a piece of paper and then adding a part on my shoulder seam so that this can lay like this here. So I added my underarm piece to my bottom part, and I added what I cut off of my top part to my shoulder seam, and I hope it makes sense. I don't know how to explain it. Of course, this curve I have to cut in a nice straight line like that. If you're not sure if you've done it right, just fold in the pleats that you made, and then you should go back to your same pattern as your basic pattern was, the same shape. So if you fold your pleats in and it's not the same, just cut it from the outside edges and you will again get to the same shape as your basic pattern was. And it's really not that complicated, but it's very difficult to explain and to do it like this. But it's a really nice way to alter your basic patterns. Okay, this is editing me, and this was really confusing. I didn't even understand myself looking back. But what you should do with that white shoulder, you saw that it was in a point, kind of a triangle, and you connect that point to the top of your V of your white paper, and then you cut off the excess at the right side, so not at the V. And then you get a triangle, a yellow triangle on top of that shoulder, and then you have the right shape and the right size. And if you really got frustrated of that, the back part will be way simpler. Also, you will need your basic pattern for the top. Trace that down again until your waist. Mark here your top back dart. Of course, you don't need this one, this is more for the front part. You can trace your neck, but we're gonna make it a V, so just mark where your shoulder seam is. That will be enough. Then you get something like this. Then mark how low you want your V-neck to be in the back. Make a straight line from your shoulder to that point and cut that off. Like that. Then I already marked on my back pattern where I want my facing to be. It is like this. I don't know if you can see it. Maybe I'll make it better with a mark, but I'll make it thicker with my pen. Maybe then it is more visible, and it's not really a straight line because I cannot draw, especially not in thicker lines. But it looks something like this. Maybe if I'll zoom you in, then it will be a little bit better. There, you can now you can see it better, huh? It's going here from the underarm, going up to the shoulder seam, then going down, and then going straight across. Here will be your zipper part. In the front, here will be your mid front seam. So for the front, it will be exactly the same, but maybe you would like to make a dart in the front when you try it on. It's especially when you are bigger busted, sometimes you will need a dart here in the front pattern, because otherwise it will gape here. And that's also always why I have tried it on, and then I'll just make my facing part, or cut my facing part, because it will be different if you have to make dart here in your front pattern. But for the back, you can now do it because you don't have to alter anything here. You can see when you try it on if you want your dart maybe to be higher or lower. It's a bit depending on your body type and on your shape. The one that I choose in my basic pattern is just a bit average, but when you try it on, you can maybe make it a little bit higher to get it more fitted through that. So this will be your back top part. Then for the skirt, We're gonna need two parts, a right part and a left part. And you can also use your top pattern for that, because we're just gonna flare it out. So you can draw it from your waist down for the skirt part, match up your mid front, and then instead of going straight down, we're going out. And just depending on how wide your skirt will be, or how wide your fabric is, you can depend on how more out you go. But that's what you need. Then you trace your dart here. And then what you do, this is your mid front, so this is where your basic pattern stopped. We're gonna add some to the sides. And that is, we're gonna add half of this pattern here to this side, and you can just do that by mirroring it and just again tracing it down. Then you have where your side seam should be, and then you add another 12 centimeters to that, because what we're gonna have is, I have the other parts here underneath laying, we're gonna add half of your front pattern, half of your half, I must say, you're gonna add, and then you're gonna add 12 centimeters for your pleats. And that is, we're gonna make a big pleat, and on top of that, a smaller pleat. So I'll show you when we're doing it. I don't know how to explain it, but you get a kind of double pleat, and you need 12 centimeters for that. And then you can add another 1 centimeter just for besides the pleat. So you take your half pattern, then half of your half, and then add another 12 centimeters. And then again, going straight out for as wide as you want your skirt to be. Mine will be 80 centimeters long. And then my width for this part is, in a curve of course, is almost 80 centimeters too. And because we're gonna curve up this top part too, so drop your mid front about a centimeter from your side seam. And again, then make the bottom of your skirt also in a curve. Then the other part for the left part of your front, you again have your half of the rest of your pattern. So here you had half from the mid front, here is your other half. So you can very easily just draw that from your basic pattern going out. And then again, add your 12 centimeters for the double pleats, and a centimeter here for the connection, or for the over underlay on your skirt. So then what you get is, you have these two on top of each other with these pleats connecting later on. So it will be pleat, 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 and they will be on top of each other. And you get a lot of pleats here, and that is because also this part is going out. Normally when you make a web dress, this will go straight down, but because we got to give this also some more fabric going out, this will, oops, very nicely fall down in nicely waves, and that gives a really nice effect with all the pleats here on top. And you can do that also for this part, you can also just go straight down for this part, just whatever you like. So that is for the front. For the back, again, you can use your basic pattern from the top and align it with your new piece of paper. Mark your dart for the back, that is the longer dart. And then going not straight down as your basic pattern was, but also going out for as wide as you like. And I don't make mine too wide, because otherwise I will be not have enough fabric, because I really need my whole width for that one front part, for that left white front part. So I have to put my left front part and my back part next to each other, so I cannot make this too wide, because but you have really a lot of fabric in the front, so it doesn't really matter. So that is for your back skirt. Very simple, very easy to do, just a straight pattern. So I have now all my pieces cut, my front bodice, and make sure you mark all the pleats and the darts and everything that we need. the front bodice. Then we have two skirts, and unless what you normally do is you cut it out of double fabric, now we have all the front parts in single layer fabric. So your whole bodice for the front, the left skirt part, and here the white skirt part. So just single layered. And here also mark all your pleats. And then the back, we need double fabric here. So I have the back bodice, and I already also cut my facing pieces here for the V and the armhole. And then I don't cut it on the fold, by the way. It is just, it gets a seam here because we get a zipper here. And then the skirt, also not on the fold, the zipper is going down here the middle. And then here mark your darts, and of course also here mark your darts. Then what we're going to start with is we're going to start sewing the darts in the back bodice. And you do that just by folding them together. I always put my top pin where the dart ends just one time in. Fold the bottom pins together on top of each other and pin them down. And then you get a really nice fold where you tuck on the upper pin and you can sew that dart. And I have a special tutorial on how to sew darts the professional way. I'll leave it up here and down in the description box. If you don't know how to do that the right way, watch that first. So sew those two darts. And what you also already can do is fold in the pleats in the front bodice. And I will fold mine up. So for the shoulder pleats, it is to the middle. And when you do that, you get some more definition than when you fold them this way, because then you fold them more down and then the pleats will fold down. When you fold them up, they fold more open. If you don't like that, then fold them the other way. But I like the definition here on this dress. And I do the same here on the bottom. I fold them to the middle. And then you can pin them down or make a temporary stitching here so that they will stay in place. And when you've done that, you put your front part on top of your back parts, right sides together of course, and you sew both side seams. Now, once you've sewn your darts in, I have pinned my pleats in here, and I pinned them a little bit higher than only at the seam. I will press that down later on. Maybe I will even sew that in. I'll see how good it will keep its shape when I just iron it in, but I'll do that later on. Now we're gonna sew, we have sewn the side seams. Now you can pin your shoulder seams and try it on and see if you need to make darts here at the armhole in the front when it is too much gaping. So this is your front part. Sometimes you just need to make here the darts that your basic pattern has to make sure that this is nicely sitting to your body. So just pin your shoulder seams together, the front and the back, and then try it on to see what you have to adjust. If you don't have to adjust anything, don't sew the shoulder seams yet. We're gonna first make the facing then for the front part. So same as you did for the back, you just trace this fabric pattern, or take your paper pattern, but then fold your pleats in here so that you have the narrowed down shoulder seam as it is now. And then make your facing like I showed you before, and same as you did for the back. So then you should have something like this. I pinned my pleats on the shoulder and on the bottom. And then what I did, I cut out all my facing pieces and I put some light interfacing onto it. And I sewed down the side seams of the facing. So the back facing onto the front facing, just sew that side seam. And finish the whole bottom edge with a zigzag or an overlock stitch. And then what we're going to do is we're going to sew these facings onto our back and front pattern. So you leave the shoulder seams open, but you're going to sew here the armhole going to the whole other armhole, or the back, I must say. Then the whole armhole, the whole front, and the other armhole, and the other back. And you sew that together and leaving all the shoulder seams open, because we're going to do that later on. You've sewn on all the top parts of your facing to the bodice. Iron open that seam and then iron it flat, that you have a really nice flat edge here on the top part of your bodice. And I would certainly suggest a top understitching it, and that is top stitching on the facing side, the seam to the facing, because otherwise it can roll open and then your facing will be visible from the right side, and that really doesn't look nice. So press it very, very well that it is nicely flat, and then do the understitching. And what I also should do is make here the V a double stitching when you attach your facing to your bodice, and then make cuts to that V to make it nicely crisp. And I see I have to iron it down again because I have a crease here and that's not nice. But first I'm gonna understitch it, then I get rid of these creases immediately. And when you have understitched it, we're gonna sew the shoulder seams. And you do that by putting your back part onto your front part. And you can now stitch the facing and the bodice together. But I like more to do just the bodice parts first, so the bottom two layers of these four. Stitch them from seam to seam, and then by hand fold in your seam allowances here of the facing, and then attach them together over your seam you made here. But first do your understitching, then do those shoulder seams. Our top nicely finished. I'm gonna hand sew the inside of my shoulder seams, and I'm also gonna hand sew here the facing to the side seams, and it stays nicely put. But this is finished for now, so we put that aside, and then we're gonna continue with the skirt parts. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna make the darts in the two back parts of the skirt. So you're gonna sew them, and that one dart that is in the white front skirt part. So then we're gonna sew the side seams of the skirt. So place your front pieces on top of your back piece and sew the side seams. So the left and the right front part. Like that, and so both those side seams. So our skirt parts are connected. Now we're first going to finish the front seams of the left and the right front part. And I already put my pleats in here. And I show you how to do that. First you make your first pleat. So put the pins on top of each other and secure that pleat. And then you take the big part, secure that right, otherwise it will get unraveled. Oh, my back is also connected. Put the closest pins on top of each other and put them together like you do for a dart. Then you take the most outer part of the pins and you put it on top of that one. So you have two pleats on top of each other, and make sure you don't really have to align them really precise. You can also just give a little of a gap in between, then you have two pleats but with some space. That's nice too, because when you wear it, it just falls open. But it's really nice because here now you have two pleats, and that gives more of an effect, especially because we're gonna stack this one on top of that one also. So then it's a really nice effect with all these pleats that are going out. But what we're first gonna do is we're gonna finish these sides. And I've been debating what to do, because I would love if I don't have stitching here, but I don't like the what's it called, press and bond, that you can iron on, that you don't have to stitch it. But I don't like it because it makes your fabric stiff. I tried with my fabric to do a blind stitch, but my machine don't get it. It's just not nice and not flat, nicely finished. So I'm just gonna do a small rolled hem. I don't know what else to do. It's not my preferred thing, but I don't have another option. So I'm gonna do that. What you can do, and that's maybe the best option, but I'm not good at it, make a rolled hem and secure it with a hand stitch. Then you can make sure that you don't have C-stop top stitching here. But it's a lot of fabric to do, and I'm very bad at hand stitching, so I'm not gonna do that. I will just do it stitching. Maybe later on I'll come up with something to do it nicer. But for now it will be just a normal rolled hem on both the sides. Well, I decided that I'm not gonna make a normal hem here in the two slip parts. With just sewing it and top stitching it, because I know when I do that I will not be happy with the end result. So I decided to make this a rolled hem and hand sew that down for both the slip parts. And I will do it off camera because it will take really while to do that. But I already made my lining part, or underskirt, or what you want to call it. And it is just a rectangle that I wrapped around my hips to have my exact hip width. Try to make it as tight as you can, because it is not nice when it's really loose here around the hem. But make sure it's not too tight that it will ride up when you walk, because that is not nice too. And the only thing that I did to this rectangle is I made here some, I call that a side seam dart. I just took it in from my hip to my waist width, so that it's here my waist width, and just make some kind of dart. And I have the opening in the back, because we make that zipper in it later on in the whole dress, and then we use this fabric together with it as one. So it's very simple to make a lining like this. And we're gonna attach it now when we're gonna attach the bodice to our skirt. And what I did, I wanted to stack the double pleats here in the front, but I think it's too much bulk there. So I just made them, I have here also the hem that I have to make. So I make them touching. So the double pleats here touch the double pleats on this side, and this is my hand that's going in between, but you don't see that later on. So they're just touching, and they are a little bit on top of each other because your left skirt had a little bit more of an overlap. So then you don't have the slit totally opening up, but what a lot, but you have nicely the four pleats here. And then what you do is you put white sides together, your bodice part on top of it, and then pin that down. Make sure your side seams and your darts in the back are matching. And then you take your lining fabric and you put that on top of that. And that means that then you are sandwiching the body part, and that makes that you don't see the seam when you flip your underskirt down, because you will get something like this, and it's here attached, so you don't see here the whole seam from the skirt and the bodice. So it's a really nice way to finish this up. So here again, match up your side seams of your underskirt and the bodice and the skirt. Pin them all together, the three layers, and make sure all your pleats are nicely put in the way they are. So I usually put some more pins like that when I stitch over, they stay in place, because it's very annoying when you have stitched and your pleat has shifted. So make sure you have really secured them when you're gonna sew them together. And then you sew this whole part together. You don't even have to finish it, because as I said, when you flip your underskirt down, you won't see the rest of it. So we'll come do that now. So now you have something like this, and what you get when you flip your bodice up and then your underskirt down is this. And that means that you have nicely attached your bodice to your skirt and your lining skirt, and you don't have a seam here. What you should do, and I see that I have that here, watch if all your pleats are secured nicely, and you see here one of my inside part of my pleat is not connected, so I'm gonna hand sew that down, because otherwise you get maybe too much stress here and it will take your pleat out. So fold that back in and then hand sew that to your bodice or to your underskirt, or what the nicest way is, that so that you don't see it, that you have this nicely secured. But you see, it's a really nice way to attach it. You saw that I had to put my pleats in too, that I didn't do. I just made my darts in the side seams, but I had too much fabric, so I had to put my pleats in here too, or my darts that I made pleats out of. So now your whole dress is connected. The only thing you have to do is put in your zipper in the back. And as I said, you just treat then your fabric of your lining as one with your skirt fabric. And because we're gonna do a blind zipper, you might know that we're not gonna first do the mid back seam first. We're gonna put in our zipper. It's a lot of fabric to show you now. Do it like this. First you put in your zipper, and then you sew the rest of your mid back. That's how you put in an invisible zipper. And if you don't know how to do that, I will link up here and down in the description box how to put in an invisible zipper. Of course, you can also do a normal zipper. Then you can first sew your mid back seam, but I think especially with this kind of fabric, it is more nice to do an invisible zipper. And then you only have to hem your skirt. So I got a lot of hemming, because I also gonna do that by hand. So I'll hand sew my slit parts, seams, and my hemline. And also attach your facing here where you need to. Usually it is here underneath your arm, otherwise it will flip up unless your understitching is also always nice to attach this to your side seam. And then again, give it a good press, and then your Indian summer dress is done. So I hope it will be a nice result.
And here's our last summer piece of this year. And I must say, I cannot show you the bag because I still didn't get my order of my zippers. I always buy them in bulk. But you saw in my last two videos, I had to take another color because I didn't get my order and I still didn't get it. And it went really out of my light color zippers. So I have now just pinned down my bag, so I hope it won't fall off because then I have to film it again. Because it's just pinned up now at the back, and when I receive my zippers, then I can put my zipper in. But still, you can see how it looks now, and I wanted just to finish this this video. And I think it looks really nice. I like all the pleats, especially here at the skirt. It's so nice. I didn't even have to bother about my lining because it has so many pleats that even when you walk, the slit doesn't really fall open, and when it does, it's just around knee length. So I didn't need that lining, but I think it's really nice like this, especially these pleats and also here at your shoulder, because I have a very short body, you don't really see the pleats everywhere, but I like how it looks. It gives a little bit more flow than when it's just straight on, and I think it's really nice. I love, love, love this fabric with that watercolor print. I'm glad that I kept it that long, but still I made the dress that I thought of that many years ago when I bought this fabric. So I'm glad with the result that I made with this this beautiful fabric. And well, this is the last summer piece. Now we're going into fall, and in my country it is not really good weather anymore. I don't think I can wear this dress anymore. So we're going to the more warmer pieces. There will be lots of skirts, lots of knits, especially the knit skirts and the knit dresses are on trend this year. And I already have some of them. I like that very much. It's very comfortable to wear. So we're going to make that in the next upcoming weeks. I hope you liked this video. If you haven't subscribed yet, please subscribe and like my videos. And I'll see you again next time. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.